I hope I don't lose subscribers. I hope you guys don't fry me. But watching as an adult, like, I became Team Derwin. Like, okay, like, let me explain. Hey y'all, it's Scale. Please subscribe to my channel, like, and make sure you hit the little bell so you're notified every single time I post a video. So I rewatched The Game as an adult. The Game has always been one of my favorite shows. I love The Game. It's just everything about it. I grew up in a football family. My brother played football, my dad played football. And so I've always loved football. And The Game is funny, it's like relatable. And as I was saying before with girlfriends, it's lighter. Like shows now, like I said, are so much heavier. It takes the whole season to figure out one thing. And so with The Game and with all the shows that we're watching on Netflix, you know, stuff just gets solved quicker and easier, and it's like not as complicated. And so The Game came out in 2006. I was like 17 years old, and like instantly, like that was my show, like that was my jam. And so the very first episode of The Game actually premiered during Girlfriends. So the pilot episode was during Girlfriends. Joan and Melanie went to Derwin's first game, and Joan, like the rest of Melanie's family, was trying to convince her to go back to Johns Hopkins because it's more prestigious, because, you know, you got into the school, this is that. And Melanie is like, I'll cut you off. I cut you off too if you keep doing this. So Derwin in the pilot episode is actually Lynn's brother. And so I don't know, did they think we weren't gonna notice? So I'm glad they actually ended up recasting him, because, you know, just a few seasons ago, you were trying to sing. You tried to have a singing career and you couldn't figure out what you were doing. Then you got your life together and you got together so much you became a pro football player. So yeah, good job for that one, guys. And then there was another Kelly Pitts, and I'm glad that they did that too, because our Kelly Pitts was like funny and resourceful, and this Kelly Pitts was kind of whiny, and I don't know. So yeah, good job on that one. I hate to say this. I hope I don't lose subscribers. I hope you guys don't fry me, but watching as an adult, like, I became Team Derwin. Like, okay, like, let me explain. So, all right, we know Melanie and Derwin, they came to San Francisco together. And so, you know, they lived on the East Coast, and they were both pretty sheltered. Like, Melanie, you know, her family was wealthy and stuff like that. And then Derwin, his grandmother was in the church. So I felt like they were really sheltered. And so they came into this fast life, and they just had to navigate it. So, you know, you see the first few episodes of them navigating that life, and just a different way of living. Even like coming from the East Coast to the West Coast, it's a pretty different way of living. And so, you know, and then Melanie's still trying to like come into her own while like being there for Derwin. And then, you know, Derwin, you know, really pining for Melanie to like be there for him and be on his side. But then she's constantly reminding him, I gave up Johns Hopkins for you. I did this for you. I moved over here for you. My parents, this, my. And so, yeah, I can understand that being just annoying, and also putting a lot of pressure on Derwin, because he got to live up to some standard that he probably made up in his head about how he has to make it worth the fact that Melanie, you know, gave up all these things for him. She didn't really have to do that. And so, like, leading up to the cheating, like, you can tell, of course, something is gonna happen. They just weren't clicking. They weren't communicating. Daryl wasn't telling her how he felt. I felt like, you know, in that instance, he could have told her how he felt. That she wasn't there for him, that she wasn't supportive of him. It just kind of seemed jokey. Like, he would make a little, like, you know, there's always sometimes a little bit of truth behind the joke. So he's making all these jokes about it when he should have just came to her and been straightforward about how he felt about her not being supportive. And then you got Drew over here, who is supportive. And so I do not condone cheating. I don't think it's right, of course. I mean, you know, who does? But like, sometimes you do have to see your part and why your partner did what they did. And so like I said, I do not condone cheating, but also you have to look at the person. So I don't feel like that's Derwin. Like, even in the subsequent episodes, like when he met new girls, he's like, okay, I'm gonna make this girl my girlfriend now. And then Jason and Malik had to like pump your brakes, slow your roll. Like, so you could tell he was a relationship person. And so it was like a cry for help to me. Like, him cheating was like a cry for help, a cry for attention. And so, and then automatically he felt bad about it. And he wanted to do all these things to get Melanie back. And so I think like the fact that, I think it made him realize how much he really loved Melanie, how much he really wanted to be with Melanie. He knew he made a mistake. And so I think those are like the recipes of, now we need to sit down, now we need to talk, now we need to go to therapy, now we need to figure out how we don't end up in this place again, as opposed to somebody who is a serial cheater and, you know, they make excuses, but they don't change their behavior. And so, of course, the best sorry is change behavior. And so I feel like Derwin was ready to demonstrate that. And Melanie, and I understand completely, just being caught up in what happened, being upset, being hurt, feeling betrayed. Of course, all feelings that are valid. She couldn't see past herself for a really long time. And but I do think them separating helped them to grow as individuals, because they came to this place as a couple, and you know, they were their only friends, you know. And so I think they needed that time apart to like become who they were to become. And so to where eventually, you know, Melanie was okay with the baby. Like, I thought like the last episode was amazing, how she, you know, in the middle of her marriage, she was like, go, you know. And when he told her the baby's name, she said she understood. And I genuinely felt that. I genuinely believed her. And I thought that was amazing, like character development. And so that was like one of the biggest differences I've seen from Girlfriends and The Game, is like character development. Like, I feel like every character developed. And so, I mean, you know, even with Derwin, just, you know, he was a nobody, you know, just getting in the league, a rookie, and then coming into all this fame and just realizing what fame comes with sometimes, and how people aren't genuinely in your corner. And then him coming up on the other side, and I think they both, you know, just stopped caring about what things look like, what other people would say, you know, because at that one point he was with Janae and tried to be in a relationship with her just for the sake of the fact that they were having a baby, and how it was gonna look, and how the baby would feel, how it would look to the baby. And him just realizing, like, you know, at the end of the day, this is who I love. And her, you know, standing up to her parents, like letting them know, you know, this is who I love, this is who I wanna be with, not caring, you know, that this was first, and somebody had his baby before she was able to, like, that takes a lot of growth. And so I definitely appreciate, like I said, that that character development. Kelly and Jason, more character development. Both of them, we find out, got into the marriage for all the wrong reasons. And I guess, you know, Kelly feeling guilty for her reason let Jason control her. And so Jason being that controlling person, and you know, you can tell it stems from childhood. His father and mother lost everything they had, even though, you know, they should have been millionaires. And so he's trying to control everything because I guess he was not in control as a child. And so Kelly realizing how constricting that was, how toxic it is, how it just didn't serve her anymore. And so she left. And I know, I can't even imagine how hard it is to leave a marriage and to leave like the lifestyle that she was accustomed to, even though it was a penny pinching lifestyle, but she was still accustomed to it. And so and then Jason kind of, you know, going through his thing and realizing, you know, that he does love Kelly, that like he did make a mistake and Kelly made mistakes. And so even though at this point they're not together, I really wish there had been subsequent seasons on the CW. Or, I mean, I love BET, but like, oh, I don't know, the way that they took it over, it just felt like it regressed a little bit. Like, they wanted drama so bad that it kind of was just like exhausting. Like I said, that's what kind of was stores. that's kind of what shows are today, like kind of exhausting, like, oh my God, like they're good, but get to it. Like, what are we gonna find out? So Tasha Mack, Ace from the beginning, from the pilot episode, because she was in the pilot episode, like you just fell in love with her character. Like I said, like kind of like Maya, like your homegirl, like you just always know somebody like that's like Tasha Mack. And so even with the man thing, and so you can tell like Tasha Mack is always trying to run away from the fact that she was a single mom and then a young mom, right? And so she always had that insecurity in the back of her head. So even when dating, it's like, you know, am I good enough? You know, I did this, I have made this mistake in the past. And even though she has became very successful, it's like, you know, that's still looming over her, you know, that mistake. And so I feel like it affected every decision that she made, even to try to run towards success and just be as successful as she was. I felt like it would just all stem from that, and it would have been great for like her to like go to therapy and just realize all that, and then just become like a super Tasha Mack, because she was like, I love Tasha Mack. Pow pow, I'll cut you, like get Cousin Pookie. Like all of that was like just super dope to me. What I hated was how they had her singing when, you know, she thought Rick played her and like took her position and she got fired from the sports agency. Like I guess it was because it was like they made a mockery, and I feel like, we're always trying to make a mockery of black women, especially in the corporate space, trying to always push them down, even though Tasha Mack was of course great. And then with Irv and then the other guy in it, like I hated that episode. I hated that part because it's like you see Tasha Mack, even if she isn't strong on the inside, she's gonna always portray herself as strong. And so I felt like they missed the mark with that one. And I literally, every time that episode comes on, I cringe. And so, then her codependent relationship with her son. And I see this a lot. And like, you know, single moms and like just not letting their sons go. Like that was the only thing. And I felt like it stunted Malik's growth. Like he couldn't be all he could be. He couldn't grow because he knew that his mom was gonna always be there to bail him out of a situation. And so if you dated somebody like this, I've dated somebody like this, like please let me know in the comments. Cause it's just, I don't know, it's like there's this phenomenon, and to where like, you know, the sons are almost like the mom's little husbands. Like it's so weird. And so, and then I guess we needed this, but Malik was like the stereotypical athlete. Like every stereotype that we associate with athletes was Malik, and he was fine with it, which was the funny part. Like he was like, all right, like that's my role, and I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna got all these cars, I can only drive one. I live with my mama. And then when I did live with my mama, I always had people over because I never wanted to be by myself and just sit with whatever I got going on in my head. Yep, that was Malik, but we loved it. And so every couple of years, they always talk about bringing the game back. And I'm always here for it. I'm like, yes, bring it back in the comments. Let me know if you would love for them to bring the game back. I'll never, especially, caveat, it has to be Derwin and Melanie. Like, we cannot bring it back with any other characters in their place. Like, I don't know what it is about them and their love story. And then me, I'm just like a hopeless romantic. So I was rooting for them the whole time, every single time. Like even, it's funny because like Jerome, like you could tell that he was a good boyfriend, a good character. He would have been great, but it's just like, I don't know. It was just that missing factor that you knew like, yeah, this would be great if they did go together. They did, you know, be together. But it is something about that Derwin and Melanie love. Derlin-y. And so yep, I really love reviewing these shows, these black shows. So let me know in the comments if you loved it. I hope I'm not being fried for being team Derwin, but yeah, I mean you realize stuff when you get older, and everything is not black and white, and everything isn't linear, it doesn't go a certain way. And you realize, you know, as you get older, life takes you through twists and turns. And so you have to roll with it. And I understand that much more now that there's no fairy tale. So I really enjoy doing these, and I cannot wait to bring you the next show. So So see you guys later. Thank you for sitting with Scale. Please don't forget to subscribe. Please don't forget to comment and like and bell. Bye, y'all.